Hi, I'm Bob Ward from Microsoft, a principal architect in the Database Systems Group. I'm here today to talk about another reason why SQL Server 2017 is built for performance. Now at Microsoft, we believe SQL Server is the fastest database on the planet. From our world records in analytic and OLTP performance we've demonstrated through our benchmarks, to the amazing demonstrations we've done at conferences like Microsoft Ignite, showing how we can scan billions of rows in a table in seconds. Now, one of the new benchmarks we've just released is using an amazing new technology from HP Enterprises and partnering with SUSE Linux, and we call this the world's first enterprise-grade diskless database. Now, let's talk a little bit more how this technology works. As I said, we call this an enterprise-class diskless database, and the reason is that HPE's new scalable persistent memory technology uses the powerful combination of memory modules combined with SSD drives to give SQL Server the ability, without any code changes in our core engine, to read data from our database files in a matter of seconds, yet achieve the amazing characteristics of persistent databases. And the other thing that's amazing about this technology is it allows an incredible reduction in hardware costs and reductions in rack space. Let's go see a demonstration of how this technology works. Now, what I observe using this technology is I can get up to 5 times or more faster query performance. And as we said, this is at 50% of the cost of a comparable storage. Now, what I have in front of me is SQL Server Management Studio connected directly to the SUSE Linux Enterprise server that's got SQL Server 2017 installed. And again, this is a server using HPE's new persistent scalable memory. Now, on this server are 2 databases, each 1 terabyte. One of them called SSD 1 terabyte. It's storing a 1 terabyte SQL Server database with files against an array of pretty fast SSD drives and an identical database that's stored against and using HPE's scalable persistent memory. And this database is using a workload derived from TPCH, so it's a very analytic query type workload. So let's go take a look at the performance of 2 identical queries running against each database. The query in front of me here is an analytic query. It's an aggregation of revenue discount data. And in fact, it's very typical of something that might be generated with a tool like Power BI. Now, on this screen here, I'm first going to run the dbcc drop clean buffers command. And that's just an internal command we use, and you can use it in your own testing, to force SQL Server to read its data from disk. I don't want to use buffer pool cache in this case, because I'm demonstrating how fast SQL Server can read data from disk using these technologies. So we'll run that command first. And I'm also using the set statistics time on command because I want to measure the exact performance of what SQL Server records in the engine to run this query. So let's run that as well. And so let's kick off this query here against the array of SSD drives. Now behind the scenes, this data is stored using our column store index compression technology, but even that type of in-memory data has to be read from disk initially when first queried. Or even on your system, if you've got less memory than the total size of your column store index data, we'll have to pull in and read those column store index segments as needed when running the query. So we'll let this query finish. And you'll see here, the result has come back. And in the messages, you'll see below the actual time it took. It took about a little over 16 seconds to run that query, which is really fast. That's pretty good to scan this much data. In fact, this is actually representing about 6.5 billion rows of data to scan. So 16 seconds is pretty good. Let's take a look at the same identical query, but this time the database is backed by HPE's scalable persistent memory. So I'll run the same commands to force SQL Server to read data from disk, and I'll also run the command to ensure I've got timings. Let me kick this query off, and we'll see its performance. And you're going to run this, you're going to see, before I can even finish talking here, the result has come back. And in the message below, you can see here it's a little over 3 seconds. So there it is, 5 times query performance. So there is the demonstration, very simply, of this technology. High-speed analytic query performance directly against storage, 5 times as or more fast, and again, at 50% of the storage cost using HPE's scalable persistent memory technology combined and powered with SQL Server 2017 and SUSE Enterprise Linux. Now, if you'd like to learn more, take a look at our main SQL Server blog where we talk about performance of SQL Server 2017. You can also go to YouTube to learn more about HPE's scalable persistent memory technology And we encourage you to download SQL Server 2017 and see how really fast it is in your environment. Install SQL Server on Linux and give it a spin in your shop. And if you'd like to learn more about SUSE Enterprise Linux and SQL Server, go to their one-stop shop webpage where you can learn everything you need to know about how to purchase, install, and download and run SQL Server on SUSE Enterprise Linux. Thank you for your time today.